What is up, everybody? This is your boy SRX Jess, and this is my full sneaker collection. Down for you. Best friends, lovers, can't seem to draw the line between each other. What is defined means nothing to a brother. You just don't give it. These Tech Runners from Axel Arigato are most definitely my favorite pair of shoes right now. They kind of give me Balenciaga slash Prada vibes. Definitely not everyone's cup of tea, but I personally just love the sporty feel of these shoes mixed with the chunkiness of a quote unquote dad shoe. These shoes are on the more pricier side, but what I will say is the quality is on point and you definitely get what you pay for. Sticking to the whole dad shoe concept, these Nike Air Max Pluses have also been in my rotation as of late. Not only are they on trend, but they're comfy as hell. They're visually and aesthetically pleasing. Not to mention, the best part is I actually found these on sale for just about 50% off the original price. Not gonna lie, I wasn't always the biggest fan of Nike Flyknits, but when I saw these in store on sale, I tried them on and I was honestly blown away by how comfy they were. Even though this shoe is super sporty, I like to kind of mix it with more everyday menswear pieces, you know, kind of get a more dressier vibe going, all the while still being cozy and maintaining that casual flex. These simple sneakers from Koyo have been a staple in my wardrobe lately. What I really like about them is right off the back, you can tell that the quality is there, you know, down to the leather with the little details. This shoe right here, although extremely simple, really does pack a punch. One thing I find pretty interesting about these shoes in particular is these shoes are technically off-white, but in certain lighting situations, they can kind of pass off as gray, almost like a cement color. These Vans Old Schools honestly don't get that much wear these days. However, there's just something about this shoe that makes me not want to get rid of it. I feel like they only look good with certain outfits, so that's kind of where the problem comes in. But nonetheless, it's a classic shoe that everyone has. And not to mention, they're extremely inexpensive. I think if I had to repurchase these, I would actually get the white ones instead of these black ones, but pretty clean shoe in my opinion. There was a time on my channel when these Reebok Classics were the only shoes I would wear. I was so in love with these joints and I still am. However, this pair in particular is just way too beat up for me to rock. I feel like the gum bottom sole really does add something to the shoe, and I feel like when styled right, you can wear these shoes with pretty much any outfit. I remember when I graduated high school, my cousin bought me my first pair of Jordans. These are the Jordan Fire Red 5s, and I remember I was so gassed when she bought these for me. I used to find any excuse to wear them. It sucks because nowadays I can't fit them, and they're definitely not my style anymore, but it just holds a lot of sentimental value, so I don't think I'm ever gonna get rid of these shoes. These Jordan Sport Blue 6s are the first pair of J's I ever bought by myself. Just like the other pair, it's honestly not really my style anymore, but I'll never get rid of this pair in particular because of the story that it holds. At the time, I was working just a regular retail job. I saved up all my money, you know, stand in line, did the whole raffle thing, and I bought these all by myself. And honestly, back then, saving up over $250 for a pair of shoes was a hard thing to do. So like I said, I don't think I'm ever gonna get rid of these just because of the story that it holds. It makes me feel good. Last but not least are just these simple classic leather pair of white sneakers from H&M. Just a simple timeless silhouette that I feel like will never go out of style. You can dress it up, dress it down, and overall you can just never go wrong with a really good pair of white sneakers. And that's it for all of my sneakers. Stay tuned for a part 2 where I show you guys all of my dressier options as well as my collection of boots. So stay tuned for that. And until next time, peace.